My lips are naked. My lips are naked in this. Be right back, people. All right. So now I look like a sane human being. Put together that young lady. All right.
Let's begin.
So today I am here because a mailman just came to the door and the one subscription box I got this summer is here. So we're going to unbox this together. Look at it. Oh, it's so pretty. So beautiful. I'm very excited. Okay, let's do this. Crap. I need to get up and get scissors. I'll be back again. To the scissors! Right. Scissors procured. And look at the beautiful box. There is a stampede of unicorns going somewhere. I don't know where. Maybe into your dreams. Let's do this. Let's open this. Let us spare ourselves the trouble. We see every person who's unboxing on live video going through. Oh, see? That's not hard at all. Oh. Here we go. Oh, come on. Yes. Ready? Okay. For first look. Wrinkle crap. I ordered this a while ago, so I even forgot which box I ordered. But anyway, card is cute. I like the card, see? How pretty it is! I love it. I can already smell it. It smells very citrusy. Oh my god. Oh my gosh. Okay. Okay, so this one is called, it's Unicorn Magic. It's by Unicorn Magic. This candle is by Unicorn Magic, I think. And it is the cotton candy fragrance. I can't say that it smells like cotton candy, though it makes sense because, you know, given our card, a carnival tint on there. And I didn't see them at first. I don't know how I'm gonna do this so that I don't fall out. If you look closely, you can see those really pretty pastel colors that cotton candy tends to come in. Look, see that pretty pastel blue and that pretty pastel pink? Look at my hair! Oh gosh, this is wonderful. I love it. To be honest, I'm more in love with the packaging than anything else. I'm happy about it. I'm happy about it. Try not to mess up everything here. Oh, it's a top. Oh, okay, it is. The second item I've pulled out is a pin, and it looks like a top hat like the ringleader of a circus would wear, and it says it's got a ticket stuck in it. Forgive my undone nails. It's got a ticket stuck in it, and it said that says admit one on it, and there's a card here. The card is likely to give information about the creator of the... Oh no, I'm wrong. It's not a pin. It's a bookmark. Oh, okay. So it's one of those cute bookmarks that you slip onto the top of your page. It is by Nerdy Girl Designs. I can get down with it. I can get down with Nerdy Girl Designs. I'm a nerdy girl. I like Nerdy Girl Designs. See, so it's got those two like magnets on the inside, and then you just clip them over a page in your book. You don't have to dog ear your book, and you can see it poking at the top of your book or whenever you open your book, just like a little floating hat admitting you into a world of adventure and magic and mystery. I like it. I can get down with it. Look, it's Cheshire. So it's Cheshire. I call him Cheshire now, because after reading Heartless, I feel quite a kinship with this character, even though Marissa Meyer's depiction isn't exactly the same kind of feeling I got from reading Alice in Wonderland exactly. But I've just kind of decided that
Shish's personality in Heartless is now canon in my brain, in my heart. Anyway, I love him. Look, look. Even the packaging looks like a little card. I love that. Okay. Let's open up Shish. And let's see. Whew. Thank goodness. I didn't want to harm him. Not gonna lie. If you give me an opportunity, I will probably use this as an earring. Because I really like it. I feel like it would fit in my ear. So, why not? This is a... Oh, stabbed myself trying to put this back in. This is an enamel pin. The Chisha Cat from Alice in Wonderland. Which, again, sticks with the carnival theme. So that's pretty cool. I like that. Nerdy girl designs. I can do it. Ringle grab. Not a coffee drinker. So. Ah! I just saw a spoiler on the card. We'll figure out what this is afterwards. I saw a spoiler on the card and I must have it immediately. Yes! Okay. So as you can see, this is an item that showcases my favorite Harry Potter character, Luna Lovegood. Oh, it's a pouch. And it says, "Don't worry, you're just as sane as I am." Yes. And it matches my hair. I am having a great box so far. I'm so pleased. The crinkly cat. You need to bear with me and not dirty this house because I am a guest here. So this is a beautiful print and it's got a quote on it from Edgar Allan Poe and it said, "There is no beauty without some strangeness." And I think it's absolutely beautiful. It reminds me of Evie Bookish design. Everything has like the same kind of color scheme. I really like Unicorn Crate. I would love to get a next one. I'm very impressed. I like what you doing. What's this? This looks like the note from the author from the book. And this looks like, alright! It's a poster from the book. Amanda Foodie. Interesting last name. I did want to read this book. So, it's not a disappointment. To get. I'm assuming. Oh! Candy! So good. Everything matches my hair. Everything matches my hair. Yay! Yay! I love it. And lastly, the book, which is a little. Oh! Signed book plate, baby. Yes. All these authors with their very nice signatures makes me feel really pressured as a writer myself to have a very nice signature. This is everything. I'm trying to make sure I got everything. Look how beautiful the packaging is. Oh, look at that wax seal goodness. Oh my good book lovergasm. This is happy reading on it. That's so nice. Thank you. I shall read happily. Yes. I feel bad. I don't want to just like unwrap it yet. Like I need to do it for the gram. Duh. I don't want to unwrap. I've got to go take photos. 2 hours later. Beautiful packaging. I am still reluctant to open the beautiful package. Okay. If I slip it off just so. That's what she said. Ooh. Know what that sound is? That sound is, hope you already took your Instagram pictures sound. Yeah, I did want to read this. So this month's book, Daughter of the Burning City. I'm happy about it. I love that everything curated in this box is like the same color. And it's not even that long. I just might read it this summer. Guys, thank you for watching my unboxing of my July Unicorn Crate. I am very pleased with everything that came in. I definitely think the box is worth it, and especially because of the care that they take in packaging your subscription. It's just, it makes you feel so good and so valued as a consumer. So I would definitely get this box again. Absolutely. I'm so sad that I didn't get their May box because I really wanted to read Flame in the Mist, but there's always next time, and there's always more books coming out this year, so grab yours while you still can and don't regret. Peace.
Love books.
Bye.